So we learned how to parameterize a test case, how to perform data-driven testing using Cucumber. The next part is learning Cucumber reports. Okay, so Cucumber has built-in reports. For example, you can have a JSON report, okay, or you can have HTML report, user-friendly HTML reports as well, or you can have JUnit XML reports. So I will just give a few examples that how you can generate a report with your Cucumber test. So I'm coming back to the runner, and in Cucumber options, I'm specifying one option, that is plugins. So reports are basically generated using a plugin, and there are different types of a plugin that you can use. If you want to give a single plugin, you can simply say that JSON, okay, and colon, and then you have to give the path where you want to save it. So generally we save reports into target folder so that it will be cleared. Target slash let's say JSON report, okay, and I will replace that backslash with the front slash dot JSON. Okay, so this way it will generate a JSON report. Okay, most of the time JSON report is very useful for integrating with some third party apps, but it is not that user friendly. So first time I will generate HTML report. I will say test report, okay. Test report is like folder name where to generate the report. And I said I want to have a HTML report. So just save it, right click, run as JUnit test. All right, all scenarios got executed, all 12 steps got executed. So it is time to just refresh your project. And in target folder, oh, where is target? Yeah, this is my target folder. You can see that test report folder is generated. Okay, because this is the path that we have given. So in test report folder, you will see index.html file. I will open that with a system editor. Okay, and that's my report. So you will see the scenario, like the feature, the scenario outline, okay, and the example, the data that I have passed. So for that scenario outline, you can see three green lines. Green, it means this is passed. So I'm saying scenario, expand scenario outline. There you can see four steps, all four steps got passed. So it is green. If any one of the step is getting failed, it will be marked as a red, and the remaining step will be marked as skip, that is yellow. Okay. Now this is for valid testing. So first time it took JSmith demo 1234. Second time is admin. And the third scenario was for invalid user ID. And that test also got passed. Actually, we haven't written any kind of assertion. We should have actually, but again, what we are learning is just a Cucumber. We are not learning, the Cucumber and Selenium together, just because our focus is learning Cucumber right now. So yeah, this is the simplest way you can actually generate the HTML report. But the same time, you can have multiple reports. So for multiple reports, I'm specifying curly bracket, comma. Now I want to have XML reports also. So I'm saying XML colon, let's say target slash JUnit XML report dot XML. The file name I will give as XML colon target slash JUnit hyphen XML hyphen report. So this way I will get the XML report also. XML reports are again very useful. Let's say if you want to integrate your test with a Jenkins. So Jenkins will pull that data from your XML file. Okay, you will publish this XML file after your job as a post build action. So just save it. I'm going to run the same class. Oh, I see something wrong. Let me find out what is wrong. Okay, I got my mistake. I am actually generating JUnit XML, but I specified XML. It has to be JUnit. Okay, it has to be JUnit and the XML file name. Okay, so I will have two reports. One is HTML as well as a JUnit report. So let me just run this feature file. All right, so three scenarios executed with 12 steps. Go to target, reload the project, and there you can see JUnit XML report. XML file is generated. If you want, you can just simply double click here. So Eclipse will open you the JUnit view, and JUnit view will show you that which task is got executed, you know, that way. If you want to have a look into more details, just open that file. Open with a text editor. The text editor will show you the XML content of that file. Okay, so it shows this scenarios got passed. You can see that, you know, all four steps from each of the scenario got passed. Perfect. So just close this. And if you want to see the report here, just I will open it as with the JUnit view. Click on the test. I don't see any failure, by the way, because this is not failed. If it is failed, then it will show you all the steps with status pass, fail, and skip to the right hand side. If any of this step is getting failed, then only. Perfect. So this is how you can generate the JUnit report. Okay. There is one more default plugin. You can actually generate your JSON report. JSON is for like API communication. If you want to, then just specify JSON or pretty. Colon target slash, let's say JSON report dot file name should be JSON. Okay, so that you will see that report into a JSON format. And I'm saying pretty. So pretty is like formatted JSON, pre-formatted JSON, that helps to understand. Okay, perfect. And now it is time to run all the three scenarios that we have. Perfect. Refresh the target folder because that report is saved here. JSON-report. Just open it. And this is my JSON report. You can see it. Okay, sorry. This is a pretty format actually. It's not exactly a JSON. Let me convert that pretty to JSON. So pretty is like, you know, just for user-friendly kind of a report. But personally, my favorite is JSON. So I'm saying JSON report now. Sorry. Run as JUnit test. Now, all right. So I see that all scenarios executed. Refresh target. Open that JSON file and you see the report into JSON format. With initially, it will show you the different scenarios, step definition, you know, and as well as the status of each step, that it is passed, how much time it took, and you know, those details. So that's all about reporting with a Cucumber. You can have your own extended reports kind of feature. You know, you can have your own reports integrated with a Cucumber. For example, I personally recommend using Extend Report or Allure Report, which has very nice interactive GUI. But for the basic purpose, I think these reports are good. That's all from reporting part.